If your web application is having form validations or the content on your page changes dynamically, then watch this video till the end because this might save you a lot of web accessibility issues. It's very common to dynamically change the content of a page without the need for a full page reload. For example, to display an error or a success message, or making updates to a section when a user performs any action. While these changes are visually evident to the users who can see your page, but these might not be obvious to the non-sighted users. Aria-live. This attribute helps fill the gap and provide a way to expose the dynamic changes that can be announced by the screen readers. Hi, I'm Skills Singh, and on this channel, I help you build web accessible applications, cover data science concepts, and share awesome UI and ADA tips and tricks. The Aria-live attribute has three politeness settings that define the priority with which a screen reader should treat the updates to live regions. The available settings are off, polite, and assertive. And by default, it's set to off. Let's start with Aria-live Polite, which is very commonly used. Any region that receives important updates should use this attribute. The screen reader will announce the updates when the user is idle, that is when the user is not using keyboard keys. Whereas Aria-live Assertive should be used when critical or time-sensitive updates are displayed that absolutely require the user's attention. Commonly used for error messages when validating a form or for the success messages. It will interrupt any announcement that is being made. You should use it with caution because it's extremely annoying for a screen reader user. Also, Aria-live Assertive is equivalent to using an attribute role equals to alert. You can use both for the same region, but it causes double announcement issues in VoiceOver for iOS platforms. Here's a useful tip. Make sure that there's only one region with role equals to alert. Because when you have more than one region with role equals to alert, the screen reader will only read the last region on your page. Lastly, we have Aria-live off, which is the default state for the elements. It should not be necessary to set this explicitly unless you are trying to suppress the announcement of the element that have an implicit live region such as role equals to alert. Now if you are new to this channel, then consider subscribing and click that bell icon to receive a notification when a new video is uploaded. Do check out this collection of videos on web accessible elements that can definitely help you develop ADA compliant web applications. Now let's jump into our code to see how we can use Aria-live and role equals to alert attributes. Alright, we have a very simple signup page where we have one text box which is a required field and then another text box for date of birth. And then we have a couple of radio buttons. For this demo, we'll be using these radio buttons to test Aria-live Polite. So what we will do is, whenever a selection is done, we will display a message what that selection was. And then for Aria-live equals to assertive or role equals to alert, we will use this button, click of this button, that whenever there is no data entered for the first name, it will throw an error message which should be read by the JAWS readers or a screen reader user. Let's get started with Aria-live Polite. I'll go to this select your sex section. Underneath this, I will define a div. So let's create a div. I've give it a class selected sex div. And then this div, we can have another tag paragraph. So to this paragraph tag, we will append the text or the selection that the user made. Let's refresh it. We will not be seeing it on the browser because we don't have any content. Now let's go ahead and add some JavaScript. I'll create a script tag, and then we have to write the event handler, but we should always write the event handlers within the document.ready. So let's go ahead and do it. We'll say document.ready, and this has a function, and within this function we have to write our code, and this should be a small f instead of capital F. Let's indentate it, end it with a semicolon, and within this we have to write the event handler. So let's go ahead and do that. We will find all the elements which has type as input. So we can say input which has type, and type in our case is radio. And to be very specific, because this can pick up all the radio buttons, we can add another selector. We'll say name equals to, and then go back to our radio buttons. So naming is used to group the radio buttons together. In our case, we have this sex radio button as naming. Next, we have to write the on change event. So we'll say dot change. We will call a function. So this will have a function, and within this we have to write some more JavaScript or jQuery. I usually prefer jQuery because it's a lot easier when compared to JavaScript, my bad. Now what we have to do is we have to find this new element that we just created, selected sex div, and then append the text that the user has selected. So let's go ahead and do it. So what we can do is we'll find this element first. This is a class selector, so I have to give dot, and then we have to find the paragraph within it. Next, we have to append. So we are appending the text that the user selected. Now within this we'll have a string. We can say you selected, and then we can concatenate it with the selection that the user made. So we have to find this male or female radio button and find the value. Now with this change, we are identifying all the radio buttons, and we can use an $.this. So we can say dollar, and within that we'll say this, and to get the value we will use a function val, and this will give us the value. Now let's save this and let's try to run it. Now when I select male, it's appending the text that we just wrote using jQuery. It says you selected male. Now when I select female, it's appending the new text on top of the existing text. So what we have to do is we have to empty this section first. So what we can use a chaining, jQuery chaining. We can say dot empty. This is a function, and then we can say it should append. So let's refresh this. When I select male, it says you selected male. When I select female, it clears out the previous paragraph and then writes you selected female. Now all this is good for a sighted user, but we have to make this compliant for non-sighted users. To do that, we will go back to our section div, selected sex div. We have to add an attribute. We can say area live equals to, so you can see there are three different politeness settings. For this case, we'll select polite. Let's save this, refresh it. Now every time a user makes a selection, screen readers will read out the change. So it will say you selected male, and user, when the user changes the selection to female, it will be read out again as you selected female. Now that was Aria-live polite. Now let's go ahead and make these modifications for Aria-live assertive. What we have to do is we will be using the error state. In this case, when I click on save, nothing happens because we don't have the jQuery event handler for the same. Let's go ahead and first add a section on top of this first name so that the error messages are displayed at top of the page. What we can do is we can have a new div. It can have the same class, which is form group. And within this form group, we can have another div. I'll say div class error div. And this div should have a UL tag, a not list. So for this case, or this demo purpose, we only have one error scenario that we are checking, right? But there can be other scenarios where we have multiple error messages. For this demo or for this scenario, we'll say, please enter your first name. You can customize it as per your needs. Next, this error message should only be displayed when we click on the save button. So let's go ahead and add a class. We can say display none. So display none is a CSS class that I have already created, which adds display none style to it. All right, now we have this error div. What next we need to do is when we click on this, it should display the error message. But before that, let's add the area attribute. That the area attribute for assertive will say area-live, and we can set it to assertive. Now let's go back to our jQuery, our script section, and write the event handler. So this is the save button. So I'll copy this ID because we have to write the event handler for that. After this, I'll say dollar. We have to find this element. We will use the on click event handler, and then we'll say click. It should be a function. And within this, we'll write our jQuery. So what we have to do is we have to put up one if condition, that if this text box is empty, only then display the error message. So for that, we have to say if, and then we have to find this element. So let's go to this text box and then get the ID. It's txtf name. We'll say if, and then we have to use the dollar sign to find the element, hashtag as a selector, and then we have to check the val. And if the length of this val is equals to zero, which means no data has been entered, then we have to display the error field. So we can say error div dot remove class. So which class we have to remove? We have to remove display none class. Let's save this and go back to our browser, refresh it without entering any data. Let's click on save button, and wow, we have the error message which is displayed in case of empty text box. Let me refresh it, add some data. I'll say Skills Singh, click on save. So the error message doesn't display. Let me refresh again, click on save button, and we have the error state. Now this error message will be read as soon as it appears on the page, even though user is tabbing through different sections. That's what Aria-live assertive does. It does not wait for the other actions to complete. It will read alert, please enter your first name. Now, instead of Aria-live, we can use role equals to alert as well, and it behaves same as that of Aria-live assertive. Next, we have Aria-live equals to off. So let's go back to this section where we have Aria-live polite. Now, there are for It can also have role equals to alert in case we want it to be read as soon as the changes appear. But let's go back to this role equals to alert. Now to suppress this, we can use Aria-live equals to off. Now even though this div is having role equals to alert, it will not be spoken by the JAWS or any screen reader because it also has Aria-live equals to off attribute. That's the functioning of Aria-live off. It suppresses the current or the announcements that the JAWS or a screen reader is supposed to make. One tip, you should always make sure that the role equals to alert is there before you remove display none. It should always be there in the DOM to make sure by the screen reader that it is being read. We have seen scenarios where we remove display none before role equals to alert is added dynamically. That causes issues in some of the scenarios. So thumb rule is role equals to alert should always be there on the HTML or your DOM before hiding or displaying the error message. Now that you have made it so far, please help me by clicking on the like button and subscribe to the channel to keep improving web accessibility for your web applications. Also, let me know in the comment section which attribute you will use moving forward, Aria-live or role equals to alert. See you in the next video. Till then, keep coding.